Let's talk today about the smart power module for a partial switching converter. What exactly is a partial switching converter? Now, the purpose of both these modules is almost the same, but their working positions are different, and today we will explain why they are different. After that, we will also explain its testing and show its schematic. Today's discussion will focus more on the partial switching converter. So first, we'll look at where the voltages come in so that it's easier to understand. Additionally, this part has become faulty, so we cannot supply power to it. The PCB isn't turning on because one of its points is damaged, and due to that, it's not working. However, for your understanding and to increase your knowledge, I'll give you a demonstration of where the electrical supply comes. Now, the first thing we'll observe is the difference between this module and the previous one. The first difference is in the pins, where we supply power and where we receive it. The second difference is that the high side and low side of this module are entirely separate. Here, the low side is separate, and the high side is also separate. Now, let's take a look at where we get the voltages. If you observe here, both inputs are coming in. If you carefully look at the inputs, you'll see positive and negative voltages. When 220 volts come through here, the input will go inside through these two pins, meaning pins 26 and 25 are our input pins. Then, the adjacent pin, pin 24, is empty. There's nothing on it. However, pins 21, 22, and 23 have negative volts, and pin 27 has positive volts. But the positive volts will be boosted here, meaning when they come in, they will be boosted because capacitors are directly connected here. So we'll get 320 volts, or around 310 to 320 volts here. The partial switching converter is used for converting AC to DC. Additionally, two IGBTs, insulated gate bipolar transistors, are used in this converter. Normally, in a typical unit, one IGBT, one diode, and one rectifier are used. Now, what's the advantage here? The use of two IGBTs increases efficiency even further. Now, it's time for the testing. Although there are many ways to test it, we'll show just six combinations that can easily help analyze whether it's faulty or working properly. In its current state, it's faulty and has shorted out, but this will also help us identify the short circuit and understand what the correct position should be. For this, you'll need a multimeter, and you should set the meter to diode mode. First, place the negative probe on pin 27 and the positive probe on pin 21. You should see a value here, and it should show double because we are checking this across two diodes. The double voltage drop is correct, and it's showing 1.18, which means this part is working fine. Next, we'll check pin 22. There shouldn't be any value displayed here, but it's showing value here. Now, what's the situation here? Both IGBTs have shorted, which is why a value is appearing here, but otherwise, this value wouldn't show. Next, we'll test pin 23. There also shouldn't be any value displayed here because the second IGBT is shorted as well, which is why a value is showing up. Only pin 21 should display a value. No other pins should. Pin 24 is not connected. Similarly, there should be a value displayed here, and then pin 26 should also show a value. Both of these are correct. So, only pins 22 and 23 should not show any value. The next test we'll perform is with pin 26. When we place the positive probe on pin 26, the value on pin 21 should show correctly, which it does, because we are checking it across a diode. After that, no value should appear on pins 22 and 23, but they are showing values here, indicating that the IGBT is shorted and connected, so these values shouldn't be displayed. When we check pin 25, no value should appear there either. Similarly, no value should appear on pin 27. This is how you can test it. Now the next point to check is pin 25. The value on pin 21 should show correctly since we are checking across the diode, but no other point should show any value. However, because the IGBT is shorted, it is displaying a value of 00. Now, if I connect it to pins 26 and 27, it doesn't show any value. Similarly, you can check all three points. Now, let's perform the second test. In the second test, we'll swap the positions of the positive and negative probes. The positive will go to pin 27, and the negative will go to pin 21. So when we connect the positive to pin 27 and the next point to pin 21, no value should be displayed here. Similarly, no value should be displayed at the next point, nor at the following points. This is because we are now on the cathode side of the diode, and the anode is connected to the negative, which is why no value will be shown here. Next, the positive will go to pin 26, and there should be no value on pin 21 either. No value should appear on pin 23, but because the IGBT is shorted, it is showing a value. However, If everything were working correctly, no value should appear here. No value should appear at the next point either. Now, when we test pin 27, it should display a value because we are checking across the diode, and that's why we'll get a value here. The next point is pin 25. Connect the positive probe to pin 25 and the next point to pin 21. No value should be displayed here, just like the previous points. However, since the IGBT is shorted, it is showing zero, but if it were in its original working condition, no value would be displayed. Similarly, no value should appear at the next point either. However, let me remind you that a value should be displayed on pin 27. If this happens, then everything is working fine. If you perform this test with the positive and negative probes on these three pins, you'll be able to check the communication between them, which will help you analyze whether it's mostly in good condition or faulty. Here's the schematic diagram. You can pause the video and check it for more details. Its part number is FSAB20PH60. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos and subscribe. Thank you.